Everybody, I'm starting this basically right behind my cheat day vid so y'all can see the weight again. I don't know if you watched the cheat day, but 165.6, pretty much up about 7-8 pounds so from yesterday because of my cheat day. So what I'm gonna do, probably gonna eat extra healthy today. I'll show y'all kind of what I'm doing. I don't want to sweat out all those basically toxins and stuff I got in from the bad food. So first thing I'm gonna do, I'm gonna drink a gallon of water. I normally drink anywhere from 12, 14, 16 cups, something like that. So close to a gallon a day. But today I'm really gonna make sure I hit my gallon. So that's the first thing I'm gonna do. I feel really dehydrated too, so that's another thing. I just wanna, cause you know, you eat like fruits and stuff like that, those hydrate you. Like, you know, especially bananas, potassium hydrates your blood, and vegetables too. Anyway, so first thing I'm gonna do on this, they kind of bounce back good. We're gonna try to see what my weighing is tomorrow, how much lower I can get it. So anyway, that's the first thing. Drinking a gallon of water today. Alright, another thing I noticed, you know, I was dealing with tendonitis, my forearm extensions for a while, and that's pretty much been gone, I thought. And yesterday, I noticed I kept getting little pains in it here and there, and I believe that's just because of, you know, all the processed food I was eating, all the junk, you know, they say eating, or, you know, just eating more processed food and junk like that causes more inflammation. So anyway, I'm excited to get back on the clean diet today. Anyway, just want to throw that in there. All right, first meal of the day is gonna be one serving of edamame, or first thing I'm gonna eat. Yeah, I don't know exactly what I'm eating for the meal yet, but I know I'm gonna eat one serving of edamame, get some good healthy greens. I'm already starting on my 6 cup. One of these bottles, 16.9 fluid ounces, pretty much 2 cups. So I've already drank 2 of them, started on the 3rd one. Gotta cleanse all that garbage out my system. So, just throw a napkin over it, pop this in the microwave for a minute, and chow down on that. And edamame, 400 calories, you get 10 grams of protein, and it's a plant-based protein, obviously, but it's a complete protein. So it's got all the essential amino acids, which is really good, really cool, and you know, it's really good for you as well. So I may be eating a good bit of that today. It's just kind of playing in my feel. I know I want to eat more vegetables and fruits today, so just keeping it healthy. So shall we?
All right, guys, having another bowl of edamame. Only bad thing, I guess it's not too bad, but one serving, which is 75 grams, has 6 grams of fiber. So, I'm already getting 12 grams of fiber in today. You know, a lot of healthy foods, fruit and vegetables and stuff, they have a lot of fiber. Even one pack of oatmeal has 4 grams. I know some of those days, man, I'll be getting like 40-something grams of fiber. I mean, it doesn't mess me going to, you know, the bathroom up, but sometimes, has in the past, you know, just getting, and there's a such thing as getting too much fiber, but I guess it's all good. That's the only bad thing. I want to eat, you know, really good like this. I don't want to eat too much fiber though. But anyway, so far, my breakfast, 200 calories. I don't know the fat and carbs, but 20 grams of protein, complete protein. That's what I really like about this too. I didn't even know that when I first started eating. I just love it. I'm so glad I found another green, or I found a green that I enjoy. And it's high in protein. Freaking awesome. Anyway, second part of breakfast. All right, third thing I'm having for breakfast, packet of oatmeal. It's kind of right here. Organic. Make the switch to the organic if you don't. I'm telling you, it's a whole lot better for you. Look at these ingredients. Organic whole grain. Focus. Organic whole grain rolled oats, organic sugar, natural flavor, and salt. That's all that's in there. Okay, now go look at the non-organic kind and look at all the ingredients in there. And tell me which one you think is better for you. So, anyway, having this may be the last thing I'm eating. Then I'm going to go for a walk. Alright, I'm actually having one more bowl of oats or one more packet of oats. This is my fourth cup of water. I really still feel pretty dehydrated. So after I drink this, that'll be 8 cups of water already for the day. And gonna eat this. It's weird. Oatmeal is really good to me, but for some reason I've noticed like after I eat it, if that's the last thing I eat in the meal, it makes me kind of feel hungry for some reason. But today, of all days, just after that cheat day, I don't mind being hungry. I really never minded being hungry. It's kind of a mindset thing. If you like keep being scared of being hungry, like you can let that ruin it, you know, your cut or, you know, your weight loss progress. But just accept that it's going to happen and be all right with it. And just don't freak out when you feel it. Just kind of embrace the feeling and actually feel the feeling. Because, I mean, I know for me, a lot of other people, I know there may be people who this doesn't happen for, but after a while it kind of goes away. It starts out kind of small, you know, it'll get worse, and then it kind of just subsides. But kind of miss being hungry after yesterday, honestly. So have this, then I'm going to walk. Oh yeah, and this puts me at 500 calories for breakfast. I think only 28 grams of protein. I can't remember the carbs. I know 11 grams of fat, maybe 40-something grams of carbs. I'm not 100% sure on that, but 500 calories for breakfast or for the first meal. So, see you on the next clip.
Just stop and gas up. All right, so what I'm doing, I'm going to the park. I normally go to the outermost trail is 1.1 miles. I normally just walk that once. I'm going to walk that twice. It normally takes me like 25 minutes, 20, 25 minutes, something like that. Close 25 minutes, so should be walking about 50 minutes or so today. I'm gonna do 2 laps, so it should be 2.2 miles, maybe a little more. Let's actually go a little bit around where it says I take a little extra little trail. But so trying to walk, get my body heat up, maybe sweat a little bit, take in the sun, let me take my shirt off, take in some sun, get some good sun rays. You know, I'm always about health and eating healthy and stuff and always walking stuff. I'm going a little bit further today. But my diet will probably be about the same, I reckon. But trying to keep it, get back healthy because, like I said, I've noticed the inflammation back and stuff. But just in that one day of eating like that, I can tell how much worse I felt. It felt good at the beginning because just the extra calories, but after you keep piling it on, you're just not getting the nutrients and the, you know, antibodies and stuff you need to recover from exercise. And just the nutrients isn't there. So I actually enjoy eating healthy. I don't need cheat meals. I don't need cheat stuff. You know what I mean? I'm fine without putting that stuff in there. So anyway, that's what I'm going to do. Walk for a little over 2 miles. 2.2 miles. 2.3 miles. See y'all after the walk.
Oh, is he gonna make it? Is he gonna make it? Is he gonna make it? Nope.
I went to the next door.
All right, change of plans. It's kind of actually chilly. I guess it's so cloudy. I don't know, actually here in the shade is, you know, kind of a little bit chilly to me at least. And one of the main reasons I wanted to come and walk, well, I just love walking, one. Two, I'm doing a little bit longer, burn a little bit extra calories after what I did yesterday. How many excess calories I had. And I wanted to sweat out some of those, you know, toxins and bad stuff that's in the food. So instead of wearing no shirt and my shorts, I'm gonna wear these sweatpants and this hoodie right here. Normally about halfway through a mile is when I feel my body temperature start coming up. So I'm gonna go do that now. Hopefully I can get a good sweat on, sweat out some of those toxins and garbage I ate yesterday. So see you after the walk.
Alright, just got back from the run a second ago. Couldn't record right after, or the walk, excuse me. Had to upload the videos onto my computer. Ran out of space on my computer. I mean on my phone. Goodness gracious, I can't talk right now. Ran out of space on my phone, so I couldn't record the video right after the walk. But I walked like I think a little bit more than 48 minutes and, you know, some seconds on there. So 48 minute walk. One of the walkways is out because a tree fell, so I had to cut it a different way. So walked about 2.2 miles, you know, give or take a little teeny bit. But it felt really good. Just drunk another whole bottle of water. Think I'll be filled this up about halfway. So now after I drink a whole nother one of these, I'll be at 11 cups for the day. And it's 2:10. You know, it's always good to wear a hoodie. Like I said, a lot of your body heat escapes out your head. So when you wear a hoodie, you know, it keeps your body heat in. And, yeah, I like to sweat. Like I said, I wanted to sweat when I went for that walk. So I got a good little sweat. It's always very important. Basically, you need to, as much as you sweat, you need to replace all that with water. You know what I mean? You need to replace all those fluids. I know water doesn't have the electrolytes and things like that, but if you eat fruits and vegetable stuff, you'll be good. So, about to have my post-walk meal. Gonna have my smoothie that I normally have. And if y'all keep up with the series here, you know what smoothie I'm having. So, I'm going to do that now. I don't know if I just said about the walk, but I said it feels good just to go out there and walk that long. I haven't done, I've never done that before. I've never walked like that. Just feels good to be moving like that, be up moving. Body temperature gets up a little bit. You feel, you know, blood more in your hands. You know, just gets to your extremities more. And another thing I really like about a lot, it's just such a perfect time to think. I don't know what it is about moving your limbs and walking like that, but I know for me, I've heard for other people, experience the same thing. You can just think super clear. And I don't know about on the treadmill, I'm sure it's the same thing in the gym. I'm sure the music would probably distract you, but I go, you know, out in nature where there's really no sound except for, you know, birds and stuff like that, so. But that's another huge plus of the thinking you can get. I mean, give that a try. I think that's really important too. If you can, you know, you have a bunch of clutter, but you can go out there and walk, get things sorted out and get things, think about things that you've been thinking about, but you ain't really given that time to think about it. You know, think it all the way through, plan out what you need to, whatever. You know, then you'll be able to get it done a whole lot easier. Anyway, I just want to say that. So I'm about to get into this, post-walk meal. Now the only thing I don't like about this blend is the blackberries, just because blackberries have so many seeds in them. So, you know, every time I get a swallow of it, I got all these little seeds in it. Minor complaint, really doesn't matter, I'm gonna keep getting this, so that's the only thing I don't like about it. Everything else is super delicious, so. I mean, blackberries are good as well, that's the only thing I don't like, those little seeds, there's a bunch of them. So another thing I want to say about your diet, you want to be getting a bunch of colors in, like right here, you know, I got anywhere from dark red with the raspberries, light redder, a little lighter red with the strawberries, got blueberries, then got blackberries, so you know I'm getting blue, reds, you know, darker blues, almost blacks, I'm getting oranges, yellows, so you kind of want to be getting, you know, then I'm getting greens in, I think I'm out of spinach, so. Yeah, no spinach in this smoothie, but you know, I ate the edamame earlier, and I'm gonna eat more. You wanna be trying to get, you know, a broad spectrum of colors instead of eating, obviously, like you saw on the full day, the cheat day there, a bunch of garbage that doesn't have like bright colors and stuff like that. So anyway, just eat your fruit and some vegetables. The more servings of fruit and vegetables you can eat, basically the healthier you're gonna be. Studies show that. You know, the less likely you are to get diseases and stuff.
Alright, so I was looking up before I blend it. Like I said, I'm out of spinach, so I just put 5 grams of the goji berries. Just 5 grams of that has 30% of the daily recommended value of vitamin A. That's based on a 2,000 calorie diet, but still 30% for just 5 grams is really well, and that's what I'm replacing. One of the reasons I get spinach is the vitamin A, and obviously it's a vegetable, so it's good for. That's one of the things that spinach is very high in is vitamin A, so kind of supplementing that with some goji berries, which is also a superfood. Spinach is known as a superfood as well, but out of spinach, so supplementing with the goji berries to get the vitamin A in there. So I got, you know, didn't want to miss out on the vitamin A.
Just got done meditating. That's one of the better sessions I've had in a while. I've been really trying to get better at that. But as soon as I always get done, I always want to stretch like crazy. So, I've already been doing some stretches. I just want to do this stretch here that I don't know what it's called, where you just bend over. Got a better angle over here actually. And I was actually starting to feel hungry a little bit earlier before I started meditating. And I'm actually excited about that. I know it kind of sounds crazy. People don't want to be hungry, but I kind of know when I'm hungry, that's when I'm, you know, my stomach's empty. That's when my body's going in, tapping into that fat and burning that fat off. But anyway, I'm going to hit one of these. Because I feel like it. I'll stretch for just a second first. Just like this feels so good. Ooh. Oh. Goodness. One of these. Baby, please. Oh. Hands are off a little bit, so reset. Okay. My lats are sore. That's for sure. All right, feel so much good. All right, oh, I'm starting to get my little bit of hunger back, which is good. Let's see, it is 8:30. Gonna be heading to my brother's here soon. Watch that Game of Thrones, a new one. Kind of something we've been doing. So, that's it for now. A little sleepy. That meditation always gets me a little bit sleepy. But when you do meditate, I recommend it to everybody. I just focus on my breath. So I focus on you, focus on your heart. There's a bunch of different meditations. I just do the breath one. And really, you got to keep doing it. Every day, you know what I mean? You gotta build the habit. I only do 20 minutes a day. And you gotta really get good at it. You know what I'm saying? Anything worth sucking at. How's it going? I'm trying to think of the thing. There's a quote. Anything worth, like, being bad at or is worth doing. Or anything being, I don't know the exact quote. Or something like that. Anything worth sucking at first is worth doing. Basically, because anything that's hard to do is worthwhile. You know what I mean? Like skateboarding or something.
you just don't hop on a skateboard and start doing all kind of tricks. It's really hard, so it's worth, you know, it's worth it to actually get good at it. You know what I mean? Hope y'all get what I'm saying. Same thing with doing backflips and stuff like that. You know, it's hard to, you suck at it at first, or even weightlifting when you first start. You don't know how to control the bar and all this and that. It takes a little time to get good at it, so. I think that's the quote. Anything worth being bad at is worth doing, or something like that. Don't know the exact quote. But anyway, give that a try. I feel a whole lot better after it. Fuck, it helps me. Mental clarity, and just feels super good. But anyway, see y'all in the next clip.
Alright, just got an averaging up my weekly averages. You can see 157.4. Okay, starts right here. 158.8, 158.6, 158.2, 156.6, 157.8. See, my last week's average was 157.8. All those are pretty much higher. Then I got 158.2. And then today, 165.6, which completely screwed it up. So the average went from 157.8 to 159. And without this cheat day recording here, I believe it was 158.03. So 2 pounds heavier without the cheat day recording, and 159, pretty much 2 pounds. Nah, not even 2 pounds with this cheat day, but got my calories down to 2,000. Like I said, right now I'm even feeling hungry, which is a good thing. So like I said, when you're hungry and your body's empty, because carbs are your body's first thing to go to for fuel, that's not there, then it's going to go for fat. You know what I'm saying? So your stored fat, that's what you want. So that's what good thing about being hungry. So going to keep it here. Like I said, just say 159. Got 4 more weeks. And maybe, I think, 4 weeks in one day. So I want to lose at the very least 4 pounds. I'll be 155. And it's not about the number, but I know what I look like at 156.6. I want to get a little bit leaner than that. So I would like to lose anywhere between 4 to 6 pounds. And if I hit 156 flat, I think I'm okay. I'm happy with how I look. I don't want to get any leaner. I'll stay there. But right now the goal is to lose really your 4 pounds, 4.1 pounds. The goal is to get 155 the very, very least. I just don't know how lean I'm gonna be there, because I, like I said, when I was 156.6, I still wanted to get a little bit leaner, but you know, I took the winter to bulk up to get ready for this summer. Anyway, that's a little update on the weights. See you on the next clip.